First, let's deal with authentication. I'm not hearing that there's an objection from authentication, as I'm understanding that the record being presented is a record that was first obtained by Mr. Knight from the Thurston County Superior Court as a portion of the transcript. Is that correct?
Yes.
Okay, so we don't have to deal with the authentication part. 904, subsection A6 refers to the documents not specifically covered by the foregoing provisions. So all those foregoing provisions are types of documents that are allowed under 904. This certainly is not an identified document in 904. But whether it relates to a material fact, which by the offer of proof it does, and having equivalent circumstantial guarantee of trustworthiness. Well, trustworthiness goes back to authentication. There's no issue of authentication. An admission which would serve the interests of justice. Then that gets us to a quick review I did. A court's oral decision is not a decision of a court until it's reduced to writing. Okay, it's an oral decision, that's all it is. The court is then required to enter its findings and its orders. And it does so based upon its oral decision. Okay, that's the process. In a related field, we deal with issues of matters that get appealed to appellate courts. There are occasions where a court's finding is needs interpretation. And in that circumstance, the Court of Appeals have allowed the court to consider oral decisions for the purposes of to aid the interpretation of the findings and to help ascertain the underlying theory of trial court's decision. The offer of proof that's being made by Ms. Voss is for that exact purpose. So the court, if we had an entire transcript of the entire decision of the Thurston County Court, this court would find that it would be admissible under 904. Now we get to the rule of completeness. Under the rule of completeness, if there is a portion of the court's decision that addresses this specific issue, and that is that court's determination that those two care providers are the two care providers are going to be identified on page 13 of its decision, then it's incomplete as it is to that issue. What I heard from Mr. Knight was that there was a host of references to various physicians, other care providers, and actions or inactions of Ms. Voss as it related to them. The court will entertain a objection based upon completeness if, by an offer of proof, the Superior Court addressed Dr. Naimi and Dr. Abdullah outside of the transcript that has been provided. Did that occur?
What do you mean addressed?
Specifically, this is why Dr. Naimi, this is why Dr. Abdullah are to be maintained as the allergist and pediatric gastroenterologist. As long as they remain in practice. That's our focus. And as I understand it, that is the limited purpose of this transcript.
Okay.
Was that issue addressed?
That issue was addressed in this transcript and part of the ruling. I do not believe all of it was addressed all in one portion of this transcript. That's why I want the whole thing.
Okay.
And the reasoning for it was for stability for the children's providers, so the children have stable providers.
And I can understand that it may be indirectly addressed in other portions of the transcript that ultimately leads the court to this writing. The trouble we have is that hearing is that we have a 4-hour transcript, a transcript of 4-hour hearing. And so I'll hear from you, Ms. Voss, in your response to his argument on completeness.
I believe it's Court Rule 11 that states that actions intended to increase the cost of litigation are inappropriate, and it sounds like that's what I'm hearing from Mr. Knight, is he could only afford a portion of it, and that was good enough for him, but he wants me to pay for the whole thing, and what happens if what he's claiming isn't in there? That is the cost on me. I believe that's the basis for this objection, just to make things more difficult for me. This is
and I can't make a decision on that issue unless I am aware of what else is in that transcript, and it's unfortunate it's a very large document. Your recitation of Court Rule 11 is correct, and if the purpose of Mr. Knight's objection is based upon it has to be frivolous. If it's frivolous, then the sanctions would apply. But I can't make a decision on that until I know what it is. So, given everything I've heard here, I'm not going to allow this portion of the transcript to be admitted at this time. I'll leave it to you, Ms. Voss, to figure out if there's another way you wish to approach it.
So, sure.
Objection sustained.
And so the question was initially regarding whether or not my perception of the children's health issues being of extreme importance and, you know, the life-threatening nature, whether or not my concern seemed appropriate based on the information available to you.
My understanding of what you had told me and what we worked on was consistent with my looking at and understanding the letters that the experts had written about the considerable and somewhat complicated medical difficulties that your children have with allergies and the gut effects of those. And so I did not find that when we spoke and when we've worked on things that somehow you were blowing those out of proportion based on looking at the actual record, and that the difficulty was how you ended up communicating with the school district and with Mr. Knight about those, but that you were relying on accurate information from the experts in terms of, you know, what the problems were that the kids had and have.
Okay. return to Dr. Delatour's report that you evaluated, I believe it's exhibit 3. Yours was 329, so hers was 330, I believe. Yeah, looks that way.
You may.
And again, I know you've gone over this so many times, but you signed off on this report, is that correct?
Yes.
And so you're aware of its contents. I'm sorry, that was kind of a question. Are you aware of the contents?
Yes, I am.
Okay, thank you. And on page 6, paragraph 7, before we get there, Mr. Knight asked you a number of questions about a person that has been in a custody case of some sort for approximately 26 years having a pattern. Do you recall that?
I'm sorry, say that again.
Mr. Knight asked you a question, again, a month ago, about a number of questions about a person that has been in a custody case of some sort for approximately 26 years having a pattern. You remember?
Yes.
Okay.
Yeah, vaguely. Yeah.
Okay. And so we have, can I also get (305), (306), (307), and (309). May I approach?
You may.
is Marianne Trouse's evaluation of myself. Is that 305?
Yes, it is.
Okay, thank you. And Mr. Knight asked, he went on to ask, has she ever spoken about Randy Holmes? And he claimed it's in all of her mental health evaluations. And he went on to us, do you recall that?
Yes.
And he went on to assert the evaluation showed a pattern for Ms. Voss' actions of taking people to court continuously. And later he said, did she tell you she lost full custody of them and was only able to speak to them for 2 hours a night on Thursdays because of a court hearing of her losing them? Do you recall that?
Yes.
And so he claimed that was all in these evaluations. And so we've got the mental health evaluation from Marianne Trouse, 2009. Can you read on page one, the last
one? I'm going to have to do objection, though, in limine, due to the age of this.
Well, let's deal with several things. There's an objection. One, this is a hearsay document. Can this witness, are you intending that this witness be utilized to support the entry of this exhibit?
Yes, I believe so. You received it and used it for the purpose of treatment.
Well, you have to lay the foundation, so.
I'm sorry, I thought you already testified to that. Did you review this evaluation and use it for the purpose of diagnosis and treatment of me?
Yes.
Okay. The second objection then is the motion in limine as far as the timing of this evaluation from 2009.
And I'm following up with Mr. Knight's question. He opened the store.
Okay. And so, and I heard the question that he had asked, and what I was listening for was a reference to this evaluation. Could you just make that connection for me?
I'm sorry. Mr. Knight stated that it's in all of these evaluations, this assertion that he was making, that I had lost full custody of the children and was only able to speak to them for 2 hours a night on Thursdays because of a court hearing of her losing them. And so he's making a claim that I'm hoping to disprove.
A court hearing of you losing them. Where is the reference to the evaluation?
He, in his objection, the objection was sustained because he claimed it's in these mental health evaluations, the facts that he was hoping to bring out.
This occurred at the previous day of testimony?
Yes.
Okay. So there was, he attempted to enter this evaluation as evidence that was objected to and it was sustained?
The line of questioning was objected to in that he was delving into something that should have been, you know, not appropriately considered by the court, and so I'm hoping to just close that.
Okay. So he asked that question, you objected through your attorney at the time,
correct.
I believe. The court sustained it, and why is the door open then?
The court didn't sustain the objection. The court allowed him to continue that line of questioning.
Okay, I understand. And again, we're talking about something that happened a month ago.
A month ago, right.
Okay. The relevance of this document is limited with this witness, and that this witness's use of this document in treatment of you. If that's the direction you're going to go, then it could be considered in that framework. Okay. asking this witness questions outside of that scope will be the relevance issue.
So the scope isn't the question that Mr. Knight asked?
And again, what I'm puzzled about is Mr. Knight's question.
My question.
Focusing on the evaluation of Mary Ann Trumps. And so if that was the question, then that's a different issue. Where, did you get a transcript? Or did you listen to it?
No, the recordings.
Okay. Did you note times?
I don't have a time. Well, I might have a time on that in the actual
I time
notes.
All my notes, and so if you could give me a time a day, I could look at the time period.
I have a timestamp of 2:40 to a question prior.
So your offer of proof is that this mental health evaluation relates to the children that are from a different father?
Correct.
I do find that he did address the mental health evaluations. I have mental health evaluation is what I have. And deals with the older children's father, and the question was withdrawn.
And then he followed up with
just a moment now. Does this relate to Exhibit 220? No, that's a guard letter report.
Yeah, no, it was immediately after he withdrew the question, then he followed up again.
Okay, why don't you, did you write down as you heard it? Okay, would you please state again what it is that you're referring to, and I'll be looking at my notes at the same time.
Okay. So after he withdrew the question, he asked during your interview, did she bring up custody issues with previous father? He said, Dr. Langer said yes with Randy. There was an objection that it was beyond scope. And so the court allowed him to continue. And then he asked, does she have two older boys by Randy? Dr. Langer answered with, that's what she told me, yes. And then the following question is, did she tell you she lost full custody of them and was only able to speak to them with them for 2 hours a night on Thursdays because of a court hearing of her losing them?
So in none of that I hear a reference to a mental health evaluation.
Right, right. In his, there was an objection to the line of questioning, and he said it was all in these evaluations. So this, he was asking questions about my relationship with the children's, my older children's father, and we objected to that, and he said that it was all supported in these evaluations, and so I'm going through the evaluations.
The witness said that?
Mr. Knight.
So there's no evidence of the evaluations?
We have the evaluations, and I'm attempting...
He didn't present any evidence of the evaluations. He made a comment.
Right. He gestured at, it's in these evaluations, and so I'm going through these evaluations.
But that isn't evidence. The court would not consider that. That's why it's not in my notes.
Okay.
I put evidence in my notes.
Okay, so what he's saying...
is never evidence.
Okay.
Unless he's testifying.
Thank you for that clarification, Your Honor.
Okay. So it's beyond the scope of the evidence that was presented.
Okay.
Admitted.
Okay.
And so what I also hear though is that this witness reviewed this document for the purposes of treating you.
Correct.
Which means that it could be admissible, but the scope is what the purpose was, that this docket was reviewed for the purposes of treating you.
Right.
And that's the, that'd be the extent of what you would be able to examine. Okay, so.
Okay.
I'm not certain that we've laid that foundation yet. If you wish to lay that foundation, I'll give you that opportunity.
In reviewing these evaluations, did you perceive any pattern of my taking, or I'm sorry, of my losing custody of my children?
Okay, you might misunderstand what I just said.
I think
you need to lay foundation before
right.
we even address
okay.
what the content is.
Okay.
Okay.
In your evaluation and treatment of me, have we discussed my prior history with my older children and their father?
Yes, and we've also discussed the psychological evaluation that Dr. Trouse did on you in 2009.
And was there any indication in there that I lost custody of the children?
Well, there was in the evaluation, it told the story of what happened as far as your having their custody for them for a while and then not having custody.
Okay, so foundation was just attempted, and so now that we have that done, Mr. Knight, it's your opportunity now to make whatever objection you wish to make.
I was referring to Dr. McCollum's evaluations. Since they had been admitted into court, I was not referring to these because I know that we have motion of limine in place, and this falls under motion of limine. This has already been adjudicated on previously. This witness was involved in that trial. We're pulling everything from that trial to this trial. I'm not understanding. We're here simply for, because Ms. Voss says I can't make medical decisions correctly for my children. We've spent 7 days here,
and
now.
We've gone through this before, but I'm looking at the amended petition, and the first prong of the amended petition says that there's been a substantial change in circumstance and that the parent has completed all court-ordered evaluations, treatment, or classes. That's where Dr. Langer comes in. And in fact, it's specifically addressed Dr. Langer. There was an order on adequate cause based upon the petition, which did not exclude that. So this court has to consider it.
Okay.
And so, however, the court is going to limit scope to how this
okay.
treatment provider treated you based upon this. The content of what is in here may only be relevant to the to that issue.
Okay.
Okay, so.
Thank you.
And so if you're offering 305 as an exhibit, are you?
I would like to offer it, yes.
305 will be admitted to that limited extent. So it's a limited admission solely for the purposes of allowing this witness to testify to the content as it relates to how we treated.
And so I believe you've already testified as to your findings being substantially similar to those of Dr. Krauss?
Yes.
And so Dr. De La Tour had similar findings?
Yes.
And so we've got an evaluation from 2009, an evaluation from 2015 that stands out as different by Dr. McCollum. We've got your evaluation from, was it 2018?
Yes. Mm-hmm.
And then we've got Dr. De La Tour's from 2021, all being the same, but Dr. McCollum's standing out as different. Is that correct?
Yes.
Okay. And the other exhibits that you have there, when we were talking earlier about whether or not you have certain things in your records, the other evaluations, I believe, I might have the numbering mixed up, I believe 307 is an evaluation of Mr. Knight?
Yes, and I do not have that.
Well, which one is that?
307?
Exhibit 307, and the witness indicated he did not have that?
Correct.
I want to object.
Well, I think you're relaying foundation, so we haven't offered it yet.
I'll
allow you to object.
I'm going to say in limine, why would it, because this is 2010, it's under a limine.
Okay, and so it's not being offered. So at the point it's being offered, I'll allow you to object. You may proceed.
Thank you. And so the 3007 evaluation is by Jennifer, I'm sorry, who? The exhibit number 307.
Okay.
Exhibit is the evaluation. Can you identify that?
No objection, hearsay.
You can identify it before the objection. Go ahead.
Yes, it's from Olympia Psychotherapy, Inc., and the author, it looks like it's Jennifer Goodwin, MA, and it is dated July 5th, 2010. And it is regarding, to address to the Thurston County Family and Juvenile Court, and it is regarding Bobby Joan Knight.
Thank you. What is it? Did you say the letters after the name M.A.?
Well, she's also an LMHC and CDP.
Okay, that's a lot of letters for me. Can you tell me what?
Licensed mental health counselor and chemical dependency professional. Sometimes. That says so below the first signature.
Thank you. Can a person with those credentials provide or diagnose personal?
Objection,
disorders?
Your Honor. There's been a mental health evaluation put in by a more qualified person than this person here.
The issue is that you are on the fringes of content. I don't know the relevance right now of, so it's not relevant yet. So
yet.
I'm going to sustain the objection based upon relevance.
Thank you, Your Honor. And so you don't have a copy of this in your records, is that correct?
I do not believe so, no.
And so would it be beneficial for treatment of me for you to know about Mr. Knight's alleged mental health issues?
In a very limited way, because my focus is on you, not on him.
Right.
And
sorry.
So, yeah. So, in that sense, I am more interested in how you respond to Mr. Knight and deal with the schools and so on, as opposed to what Mr. Knight's problem may be.
Okay. And so I didn't, it also says confidential, is that correct?
I don't see that there, but maybe it says there somewhere. Yes, it does, yeah, on
and
the second page.
Would it be against the law or inappropriate for me to be disclosing that to you or to others without Mr. Knight's?
I'm going to continue to sustain the objections right now. You're asking questions that have no relevance that I've been able to figure out yet, so.
Okay.
If you have an offer of proof as to where you're going, or I want to call you counsel now, Ms. Voss, you can make the offer of proof, but
okay.
Right now your line of questioning, I can't find any relevance.
Okay. The point being, I didn't go to Dr. Langer to prove things about Mr. Knight. I went to Dr. Langer to deal with me.
Okay.
And that's pretty much the extent of.
Okay. So why are we addressing this proposed exhibit?
Well, the question previously was in regard to having four evaluations, mental health evaluations regarding me in various points of time. We've got Dr. McCollum standing out is very different, and we've got two evaluations for Mr. Knight from similar points of.
We don't have two evaluations for Mr. Knight unless you could point them to me.
That would be the next exhibit.
That has been admitted?
Not yet.
And this, you believe this witness will be able to admit, to provide the foundation to admit that exhibit?
To the extent that there are two evaluations. Mr. Knight has not objected to the second evaluation being admitted.
Oh, it's been admitted?
Yes, it has been.
Okay, so the second one is you're going to ask him questions about the second evaluation.
Yes.
Okay, so why don't you move on and deal with that?
Okay,
thank you. Let's not deal with this exhibit 307. I don't think it's been offered, but it's been asked about, and so I'm going to sustain the objections.
And so 307 is.
I think it was 307 that we were referring to, yes.
The evaluation by by Jennifer Goodwin, and the evaluation by Dr. McCollum is 309.
I don't see 309 being.
309, yeah.
I see that it was.
I don't see 309 being.
I think I submitted that one through mine.
Oh, so it'd be your number.
It was the same as 215. It was. Addressed, but it wasn't properly offered and admitted. It was identified, it was referred to.
It's not admitted.
Correct.
It didn't get admitted?
It did not get admitted.
Oh, no
objection.
215 is admitted.
Yeah, 215.
If that's what you're talking about.
Oh, 215 is admitted.
Yes.
Okay.
Okay.
Okay. I'm sorry, there's just three copies of everything.
I know.
And so, can I get a copy of 215, which is the same? Can I get the exhibit? It's not a copy of the exhibit. And so the evaluation by did you know that Dr. McCollum had done an evaluation of Mr. Knight as well?
No, actually. I think you told me, but I have not seen the copy of it.
Okay. And that was fairly recently that I told you?
Yeah.
And so again, there's no utility in my bashing Mr. Knight with mental health evaluations with you, is there?
I suppose not. I'm not treating Mr. Knight, so I wouldn't have an opinion about that.
Right. And so the court has two evaluations before it. One's been admitted from 2015, another that has not been admitted from 2010.
So we don't have two evaluations before the court, we have one.
Okay.
I just want to make sure we're clear here.
I am trying to get there. But the court does have four evaluations before it regarding me. And so part of the things that we have discussed is, let me finish that thought first. Should the court be concerned in that Dr. McCollum's evaluation is so disparate from the other three evaluations? Is there potentially some oversight that Dr. McCollum?
Objection. How can he figure out if Dr. McCollum hadn't done something right? That would simply be his opinion as a medical provider or a psychologist. Dr. McCollum has his own. How can he testify to what he did wrong?
Isn't this already addressed in direct?
I don't know that
my
was.
Recollection is that these questions were asked. My recollection, again, from a month ago, was that this witness testified to, yes, they were different. Testimony was that it's very difficult to disagree with Dr. McCollum's diagnosis at that time. She, referring to Ms. Voss, has evolved quite a bit, no longer holds true at this time. So that was his analysis of Dr. McCollum previously. So I recognize that there was a cross-examination with regard to this issue. And so you do have some latitude, but I don't want you to replow the same field that you plowed the first time around.
Thank you, Your Honor. And so I'll ask again, when we have four different evaluations, three being very similar and one standing out as different, is there reason to believe in a professional sense that Dr. McCollum's opinions were less credible than the other three, or did I change in each of these evaluations?
Well, again, it's difficult to know that specifically because I saw you when I did and not when Dr. McCollum evaluated you. People oftentimes are at their very worst time when there's a lot of stress regarding breaking up of relationships, challenges with children's custody and so on. And so I'll certainly stand by my opinion of you and what I believe is correct. I don't agree with Dr. McCollum's conclusions, and I think I can base that on 116 hours worth of our getting together as well as reviewing the other information that I have in my chart, as well as things that you provided me that I handed back to you because I didn't want my chart to get that thick, and it didn't seem like I needed to keep that particular information in my chart. I think that you have really benefited from treatment, that it is that you've gotten considerably better. I'm impressed with your legal skills, that the judge almost called you an attorney by saying counsel, because you're dealing with a lot of difficult things here, and they're emotionally loaded too, because it isn't just about winning a case, it's about your children. And I continue to be impressed with how much you've actually taken what you and I have talked about and taken constructive criticism about how to approach the school district, Mr. Knight, and others in dealing with things, as well as the fact that what I can see through the many times that we have gotten together, that you are really concerned about the kids in a genuine way and not just for your own purposes, which is what Munchausen by proxy or other kinds of things would indicate, that I do not see evidence of that. And I do believe that that the evaluation that I made, and that in fact the most recent one that Dr. De La Tour made, is an accurate reflection of how you're doing, and that obviously has, in my opinion, positive implications for your ability to parent appropriately, although I did not do a parenting evaluation, so I didn't do that piece of it, but it's who you are that I evaluated, not the interaction between you and the children and asking their opinion and talking to them. So I have not done that part. And that would not be appropriate at this point, because I've been the treating psychologist for you, not for them, or for the family for that matter.
Right. I'm asking the court to decide or to approve a parenting plan that requests that Mr. Knight have a mental health evaluation before he asks for the contact with the children. Is an evaluation by Dr. McCollum from 2015 the best evidence as to Mr. Knight's...
Objection, speculative.
Let's wait till we get to the bottom of the question.
Is that, I'm not sure if best evidence is even the right word, is that evaluation sufficient for the court to make a determination as to Mr. Knight's current mental health, or is the request for an evaluation appropriate given what you've seen and given the dates of the different reports here?
Okay, so there's objection.
Go on, sorry.
So your objection, sir?
He would be speculating.
Two parts of it. Well, it's all based upon the same thing, foundation. That you need to ask the foundational questions about whether this witness could even testify on anything that you just asked.
Another part of the objection is he has never really spoken to me other than me being a question in court.
And I understand. It gets you back to the whole speculation thing. And so foundation is going to be based upon speculation. Right now, I don't know how this witness can testify. So
okay.
I will sustain the objection.
Okay.
If you wish to lay the foundation, you may proceed.
The evaluation that you have there of Mr. Knight, by Dr. McCollum, does it indicate any serious mental health problems?
Mm-hmm.
sorry I can't direct you to a page because, well, I know on his page 28, he starts with the questions, the same questions that he answered in mine. Strengths and challenges. But there's no diagnosis portion in this evaluation right above that as there is with mine.
So I really feel uncomfortable having an opinion about Dr. McCollum's report on Mr. Knight.
Right.
But I do think I can speak on your evaluation.
Okay. Okay, that's fair. And so if Dr. McCollum saw no concerns regarding Mr. Knight.
Well, I'm talking about your evaluation.
Okay.
If this witness just answered the foundation question, it says he's not,
right,
he's not able
right.
to provide an opinion on the with regard to Dr. McCollum's report with regard to Mr. Knight.
Okay.
So we need to move on. In fact, it's 3:29, so we will pause. We'll take a recess for 15 minutes. Back at 3:45.